Welcome back. We've all seen them, the balloons, homemade signs, cheering families, welcoming our returning service personnel home.
But once they've returned from their missions overseas, a new one begins at home, one that can sometimes be hard to identify.
News Channel 5's Bridget Shanahan has more in the first part of our special report, Mission Homefront. Bridget?
That's right, George. As more of our troops return from overseas, many of them are finding themselves suffering from PTSD and depression. But those aren't always easy to identify, especially in yourself.
Thanks for service.
Welcome home. Now I don't see myself as a hero. Well, I'm doing what people did before me. Sometimes you're excited about being home. I'm home. I'm free.
I missed you guys.
Well, about 6 months down the road, then it comes. You know, then it really starts to affect you.
After the homecoming celebrations fade, some soldiers tell us they're left with the sounds of what they left behind. Videos like this, filmed by a soldier during an attack at the Bagram Air Base in Afghanistan, quickly bring Sergeant Chris Jenkin back to his mission overseas.
I'm proud of what we do.
He spent 28 years in the military. His most recent deployment was his third. Coming home after his first trip was the hardest. Sergeant Jenkin didn't know he was suffering from post-traumatic stress disorder.
To be quite honest with you, my first marriage fell apart, I believe, because of that. We couldn't communicate, and it got harder and harder. Mm-hmm. Hence, ended up a single dad with three children.
Does it get hard for you to hear all these stories?
Oh, sure. I would be lying if I said it didn't.
Ann Lopez is a clinical social worker at the VA in White River Junction.
Sometimes it takes a while. It might be a month, it might be 2 months, it might be a couple years before they or family members realize that, you know, you'd really benefit from some help.
Sleeplessness, anxiety, avoidance, irritability, all things that come along with PTSD. One study finds that nearly half of our returning troops suffer from PTSD, depression, or both.
We're in an area of operation at a high mobile, high operational stress, 365 days, and we get home, and now we're supposed to turn off the switch and become a dad again, and it's very difficult, very difficult.
One of the biggest problems is actually getting returning soldiers to come to the VA for help. That's because a lot of times veterans find it hard to admit or even realize that there's something wrong.
You know, they're trained a certain way. It's just complete the mission. You need to do this. You need to, it's just soldier on.
The denial and reluctance to seek professional help is something that frustrates those who know you can recover from PTSD.
Sometimes I think psychologically I need to know what's going on too. And as I know what's going on, I can understand it more.
He has long possessed the courage and grace under pressure to enter a combat zone. But Sergeant Jenkins still finds it difficult to talk about seeing his psychologist, even though he knows she's helping him find the strength to continue as a soldier and a father.
I'm that person that went and took that extra step. Will everybody? No. But I hope they do.
Well, Sergeant Jenkins says his girlfriend helps him calm down when he feels himself overcome with frustration or anxiety because of that PTSD. Now, the support system is really important, whether it be family, friends, other soldiers that can help you out. But if you are alone, there is a new thing that can help you cope by yourself. It's an app for the iPhone. They're working on one for the Droid as well. It's a PTSD coach that you can go to when you're feeling stressed out or overwhelmed with something, and it'll help walk you through steps to help you calm down. And that's something you can always have with you.
Yeah, Sergeant Jenkins very open about this.
Yeah.
He said it when you said grace under pressure.
Mm-hmm. He was very candid, and I think in part because he wants to help other young veterans who maybe don't realize that they have the same problem he did before he knew. So coming up tomorrow night on News Channel 5, we stop by the home of a local military family to see what it's like for those who are left behind while their soldiers and their loved ones are overseas.